Radiant Team ban.
Not really sure.
Dire team pick.
Yeah, crit's the man, dude. Let me see.
Beastmaster.
Alright, commands. I mean, it's a draft anyway. It's the best time to do this. Turn off the other. The Toonskis. I'll just make it NEL, because that would be the most common thing, right? That seems to make sense to me.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Are you serious? You really gonna do that to me? Alright, there we go. That's nice. Let's change that. Automatically repeat. Nice. Okay. So now, from now on, guys, I like that.
Radiant team pick.
That's pretty good. I think Grant's just chilling. I don't think Grant's actually casting tonight, is he? No one can compete with the Grandmaster. Don't,
10 seconds remaining.
Don't think I'm such a fool.
5 seconds remaining.
Juggernaut.
Alright, so that's pretty good. So that should auto-repeat. So that's good. Taro played earlier, but he is not on today. Let me, who do we have? So we have MSS, Fear, Miracle, Kitrak, Vita, Arteezy, Crit, Pendago, Tomato, and Squee. Alright. I...
10 seconds remaining.
That's pretty good.
We got another Beastmaster!
Got an Oracle pretty early on, but False Promise, right? It's decent. Versus the old Beastmaster Roar, I like it. And then the Juggernaut. Very standard core. Having a good time so far. We're rocking Jameson's Irish tonight. Okay, we finally finished off my Duty Free bottle. So, shout out to Duty Free. Being in the Socialist Republic of Canada and healthcare. There are severe taxes upon the alcohols, so take your duty freeze when you can get it. And so that's what we did. So rest in peace, duty free. It's been lovely knowing you. Times are changing. And it'll be the Witch Doctor. Haven't had him in a while.
Radiant team ban.
Invoker banned out here. No Arteezy Invoker to pair up with the Beastmaster. Not too surprising, I suppose. The Sunstrike action. Grant has vouched Merlini. Nice. Merlini thinking about joining in, eh?
10 seconds remaining.
I like it.
Five.
Jin is the alcoholic champions. Jin is actually so good. Jin is like
Dire team
with back. Cranberry? Oh my god, it's so good. Crantinis? Highly recommend.
Radiant team.
Alright, bands come out. There's our witch, Faceless Void. And again, all the offlaners are gone here. You know, it's risky for the Radiant side here. Miracle not taking an offlaner very early on. Who's left? Tide, in terms of like big ones. Although he got voided earlier.
10 seconds remaining.
Not many of the real bad boys left.
Reserve
pretty much
time.
Beast, Faceless Void, and Darkseer that are like total tier 1, you know? The real heroes. We still have Terrorblade once again here. Eldritch banned out very early. Ricky banned out. Can be pretty troublesome for him with the silence as well as, of course, the natural order. Take care of all that very solid armor. Maybe someone will want to whip out a little bit of a Terrorblade later on here. We'll see. Oracle pick, always a little bit scary going into like Huskar plus defensive support. Can't really be too certain. Even with the Juggernaut, could be mid. Highly unlikely. And the Rubik. Oh, that's a good Rubik game. Roar and Witch Doctor. Okay, actually, maybe we shouldn't say that. Because, of course, Death Ward, as long as you're smart, they should never get it. But even Cask is a nice steal. Just a solid support, too. good support with a Juggernaut too. But there's a Shadow Demon! What are we talking about? Maybe it is going to be a Terrorblade Shadow Demon play. Oh, and speaking of the devil, jeez, guys, we are just shouting at all these heroes right now. Tidehunter makes an appearance, a Shadow Demon, they'll go with the Axe. That's another solid combination. Those illusions getting a little bit of a spin, you know? You can make some plays. But Shadow Demon Beastmaster, another combo. He used to be Shadow Demon Beastmaster Invoker, though.
10 seconds remaining.
So it's, one would assume it'll be mids left for both teams. Medusa banned out. Would have been a lot of space between an Axe and a Beastmaster for Medusa, gotta say. Banned the Ursa. Some very tanky mid, perhaps.
Tinker.
I'll just go with Tinker. The Axe of the Beastmaster, I can understand. And Tinker, I mean, this is a really good Tinker game. They need a mid that can do decent at catching him out. But right now, they have Ty, Jug. Kind of hurting for, like, follow-up control. Like a Puck or something. But then you have a Puck versus an Axe of Beastmaster and a Tinker.
5 seconds remaining.
Beastmaster, Axe, Tinker. Percent, like, Death Prophet's actually not bad. She's okay. She'll get roared, but you have False Promise. Yeah, I think Oracle Death Prophet, percent-based damage on an Axe. The only problem is she still doesn't help kit that's Tinker. And you have to start to think, like, how are we going to kill this damn Tinker? You know? How are we actually going to catch him? Do you go back for, like, a mid-jug and you pick up some sort of a carry, like a Spectre or some shit? You go, like, totally YOLO? Did you go... What if you went mid-jug into a Sven? Could be really good. The Blade Mail from Axe could kind of fuck you. But other than... the Purge from Shadow Demon. I mean, that kind of fucks everybody, though. It's a hard draft. Tough game here. Magnus mid? Do we just go all Womp? That's not bad. Actually, Magnus is okay. If you get the Magnus Jug combo, get a follow-up after Tidehunter Ravage, the Rubik Blink later on for the Tinker, plus the Blink on the... Yeah, no, no, Magnus. Oh, they're doing the Spectre. I don't like it. I don't like it. I mean, that's the core move. If you want it, it's the Haunt under the Tinker. Throw the mid Jug, but I don't know. RTC wants the support. Help, yep. Tomatoes, he's throwing out the flames a little bit here in the all chat. In the NAL chat.
Prepare
all right. Tinker's not supporting. Or rather, RTC's not supporting, guys. He hopped on the Tinker. So let's go over everything. Rating side, it'll be MSS taking up the offlane. I like it. He's going straight. He's got his tangles and his wards, and he's going to see who's up here. He's like, what's my life going to be like? Am I buying an Iron Town? There's crit on an Axe. Yeah, I'm taunting my ass out of here. No thank you. I'll pass. No, if it's just an Axe, he can stay. He can man up versus the Axe. That's no problem. We'll see when he decides to buy his items. Probably when the lanes have actually taken a little bit more shape. Buy Iron Talon crit. He's down, man. Fuck off, dude. Oh, oh. Can we do it? Can we do it? I'm sorry. I really just want this to work well. Ah, it's so good. I'm going to make like 10 of these things. Wish I was Axe. I'd body this lane. Crit. Giving him the flame. I like it. All right. Arteezy and Pantego. We'll finish up the rating side first, though. So, Miracle, he's going mid on the Jug, as expected. Here, down here. On the Spectre. So, this is the reason why we talk about this. Man, the Spectre versus the Tinker. I know, guys. Now, stay with me. This is going to get really complicated. But Tinker moves around the map a lot. But when Spectre presses... if you're a noob Dota 2 player who doesn't use Legacy like myself, you can immediately appear on Tinker. Isn't that crazy? Can you believe that no one's ever thought of that before? And yet here is Fyrdo doing that. Wow. Crazy. So that's why you see that. And he's going to be supported by Pepita. Team Icerus. Solid, South American squad. They do their thing. And then it's going to be someone who I'm totally going to about to be flamed for here. Oh, is that Scree? No. This is Radiant Side. Oh, that's Kitrak. Kitrak on the Oracle. Alright. KR, gotcha. So Darkseid, Scree on the Shadow Demon. As mentioned, Crit going to be up top on the Axe. RTZ mid Tinker, Pandago reprising his 5 roll this time on a Witch Doctor instead of the Crystal Maiden. And Tomato in the offlane. On the Beastmaster. Alright. Lane some early Pepita appearance, perhaps. Right, correctly assuming that Pandago will be around. Now, this is a little bit risky. He's showing up here with a ward, so you can't really ditch it mid, but as a ranged versus a melee would have been kind of nice. Oh, RTZ just accidentally fairy fired, didn't he? Yeah, he totally did. Oh, GG. It's over, guys. Oh, RTZ, please. Life. Top lane. Yeah, he bought Iron Town. And MSS just realized, you know what? Fuck this shit. 2 supports, an axe. I don't think so. And not having any of that life. Sorry, lovable thug. I hate to disappoint you. I mean, I came here for the Grand Cast too. And for some reason, they threw a mic in front of my face. And, you know, this is just how we wound up, so apologies. Man, this Oracle pick was just, like, pretty solid. You know, I'm kind of down with the Oracle pick this game. He gets flamed a lot, but you got the Nuke versus the Beastmaster, you got the False Promise versus the Beastmaster. He just, like, I feel like he's a better counter to Beastmaster than he is Darkseer, honestly. Yeah, the whole Iron Shell thing, you purge Job of Fortune's End, but Beastmaster just gets, like, totally fucked by this guy. Tomato's, like, stacking Ancients. Nice guy, by the way. Gonna help out his Axe here pretty handily. They didn't block off his camp either, so he still has this to go back to. Right now, he's just trying not to be First Blood.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Miracle. He's almost up to his bottle here. Bendago still kind of chilling around mid. No help required top, so he's going to leech some of Arteezy's experience. Probably get flamed a little bit here for it, but he'll be out of here in just a second. Jared, Fletcher, Dota. Arteezy doing the standard blind you while you try and last hit any sort of melee versus him. Eric, let's go for the healing ward early on. This is kind of your standard Jug versus Tinker play. Crit up top, nothing to worry about. I mean, look at the man. He's 70 HP. Doesn't give a shit. Salve up here. Pushing forward, and one at the tower. Play here, this is really nice, eh? So they block this off, right? And the reason they block this off is because you have an axe, and you know you're gonna push the lane. Unless you do, like, perfect pulls every time with Scree, who, by the way, is a god and keeps getting them off anyway. But just because this is blocked, it means you can't just Iron Talon here and come up and soak near the tower every time. And this just commits MSS fully, full jungling. Now, in that sense, he does get more GPM and XPM just because he's, like, staying around this general area. It's much more efficient, but he doesn't get that nice boost of waves coming in, right? So, no concern top. Just really well executed in the laning stage here from the Dire side. I really like the fact that they're stacking from Tomato. This is going to be huge. Like, overall, they're kind of crushing. Anyway. TZ. Doing pretty damn well mid, kind of what you'd expect, 24 to 11. Not really much else Merrick can do, honestly. His bottle's coming in now. Yeah, both safe lanes. Just having a time. Now, what's going on, Fear? I mean, this is only because I expect a lot from you, Fear. You have to understand. 27. 4 minutes in. I guess maybe it's just a little bit of inflation here from the axe. It shouldn't be so critical, right? I mean, obviously he's jungling a little bit here. Probably it is just 7 waves, and you know, or rather, you know what I'm saying here, 5 waves. I'm sure Fierce is killing it.
I'll take that.
4.5 minutes in, And once again, now Vanguard already done for crit. Holy shit. Useless Vanguard. This makes it some damn easy for Squee just soaking up all of this experience up the safe lane. God damn. Oh man, oh, this Vanguard is actually so good. Crit is gonna be getting into boots. He's gonna be hopping into some Blink Dagger. And look at the damage on the Radiant side. Their magical damage, yeah, there's Oracle Nukes and there's Rubick, but realistically, like Ravaged. That Vanguard is gonna be disgusting this game. Holy shit. Oh, he's gonna create so much space in this mid game right now for this Tinker. They have no roaming supports to come in here. They got the Juggernaut and Miracle, right? I mean, this is a hero that you expect to be able to contest these kind of stacks versus your Alchemists or really any hero that wants them, but it's too early. It's 5.5 minutes in, you know? This is like an 8 minute hero who comes in and contests. Man. Miracle, is he gonna go peek? He's probably thinking about with a Zombie Slash. A little bit too risky. He needs some help. Maybe if they were like smoked up. Oh, there are some smoked up supports. Oh, speak of the devil. Good timing to come in here at the level 6. They need to go. Alright, there's a circle drawn from Mr. Kitrack. He knows. They are correct. Oh, they're even gonna scan to guarantee it, Miracle. Oh, he didn't go for the bottle. My mistake. He actually went for the Soul Ring. I just naturally assumed it was a bottle. Under attack. Gonna get spotted out. There's your lift. First nuke. There's the purge off, but Miracle? Oh! Can't find it. He's too tanky. They're like, holy shit, that's a Vanguard. We can't kill this fucker. And there goes running away from MSS. He has the Ravage. If they could sandwich him, it would be great, but Crit's just driving three heroes back. He's like, you want this? Is this what you thought you were coming to the jungle for? I didn't think so. Driving him back. Oh, what a waste of time for the Radiant. Man, nothing. Alright, that's 7 minutes. I'm taking it. Right over to that net worth graph. So now it's Bandago's turn. He gets the soak up top. Only level 4 and a smidgen of his way to 5. He's almost there. On lane, Tomato able to come back down with a couple levels. He's got 4s up to 3 points. He can tango with someone like King or Kitrack rather. I'm gonna keep calling him King R because I do that KR every time. But 3 heroes now. Maybe they can move with these phase boosts. They have the Haunt as well. Ooh, but it's gonna be a dangerous play if they do. Crit's coming down. This is gonna be so much gold towards his Blink Dagger. Tomato's actually trying to bait it in, but he can't get the roar off in time. He needs to get a lot of someone. Oh, that nuke, not quite enough. He's gonna start healing up, making his way into the trees. And now they're gonna come in with the Haunt. Still looking after Tomato, but the casket's bouncing through fear. He can't get a Haunt off. He keeps getting stunned up, and now he is down. It's first blood for Squee. 4 heroes down here for the Dire side. In fact, it's actually the full 5 as they've rotated Arteezy as well. And they get themselves a double kill and transition this right into an easy push. Oh, it's gonna be 500 gold exchanged over, and Merc, he's asking what's going on with the old grapple. Oh, shaboom! It's up to 2k now. Oh, it's looking good. Artur and the boys. I mean, Crit Dota, honestly, is just carrying this game right now. I mean, what did he have to do? He just sits in lane, he gets some gold, he buys a Vanguard, he goes to the jungle. Both the supports get some experience. Oh, it's nice. But you don't get much better than that. The DD rune up here for Miracle, and he hit a, you know, maybe hit a bottle. He could transition that into a free solo kill, but he'll try his best without it. Gonna try and wander himself in Dire side vision. They don't have anything. They don't know this is here. Oh, Crit just took that full stack. That's a blink. Oh my fucking god, Crit is so fast. Jesus Christ. Oh nice. Okay, Squeeze coming to the stack. Miracle, don't leave yet. This is it. Oh yeah, got him. Alright. See Omni Slash. So, Miracle, he gets some sort of recovery. The first kill for the Radiant side, but my god, that stack is just merciless. And Crit Dota gets the Blink Dagger up. Mopax's voice is far too cool for how he looks. Alright, I'll take it. You know, I'm fine with that. It's, that's a net compliment, you know? Call it a Pyrrhic victory. It's fine. March. Wow, 4 points here for RTZ. He's just like, I don't have to do shit all this game, guys. I don't need lasers or rockets. There's no hero in my lane. I just want to get some Skrilla. And Crit comes in, a little bit of help there. Doesn't even need to finish it off the Slam Jam. Probably a little bit disappointed, but doesn't have to wait the 60 mana. And now we'll have a little bit left here for a call on the Miracle. No TP scroll, not that it would really matter. There's the Purge to slow him down, Healing Ward, trying to keep his distance, maxing it, and that will keep him alive. MSS having the Ravage, scaring off the Dire side, and he doesn't even have to pop it. So a win-win situation there for the Radiant. Unfortunately, they lost an Oracle. So overall, it's away the Dire. I believe that's Pandago yet. For 60, okay. And gets himself a Tome of Knowledge, nice. Alright. And Dego having a great minute here. Probably about half the experience he's going to earn over the next 5 minutes or so was just garnered for him. Kill and a Tome. Good stuff, good stuff. General item check right now. MSS going in towards that mechanism first, expecting some early aggression from the Dire side. Can't really blame him with crit. Extremely rich. Blink Vanguard. Everyone else, though, they're trying to catch up. Trying to get a Necro from that Beastmaster. Does he have it? Thought maybe he might just like Mega Fern, but no, he doesn't. He's way down there. 34. No one can keep up with crit. Probably could buy some boots if he wanted to. Might just save up for bots, honestly. Kind of game he's having. Tranquil's really required here. Inside of it. Look at crit right now. I mean, they can't kill him. They'd have to use everything. As long as there's anyone nearby, he should be fine. But they've already taken bottom, so he can't just like cut and use the Vanguard for that. Could theoretically come. That might be the play. However, it's so weak anyway, it doesn't matter. Oh, can't really do too much. Top lane. Pita, spotted by Scree. A little bit of play here. Smoke Nap purchased that from Rubik here. So maybe trying to make good use of this first Ravage. They still haven't popped it. MSS holding it in defensive purposes. But now he's a mechanism. This could mean a good fight for them. Killing crit would be massive. So much unreliable gold. Definitely know you're getting that full death cost of the 300, but crit is just a monster. You know, Tinker not being able to farm agents anymore, handing all over to him. And now this is disruption save here from Squeak. RTC will still go down. I mean, Hero Suck cast is bouncing, but that mechanism from MSS actually making the saves here. Gush comes out, secures the kill on the Pandago. Even the score up at 3-3. And the Graph might start inching its way back up towards the Radiant here. It's crit Dota though. 2k gold. Question, does he go eggs? What's their HP pools like this game? This is actually a decent eggs game. Maybe they tied. The cores are pretty brutal. They buy a lot of stats though. Either way. Squee, he's caught out. The Radiant, you know, they're working as a team here. Dire side are decently farmed, but they don't really have the heroes to actually pair up with crit, you know? He's got this Vanguard, he's got this Blink, but you look at someone like Tomato. He's trying to build a Necro here. Arteezy, he's trying to get his first core items up. He only has bots. He's not partying. Pandago as well. It's much more difficult than someone like MSS. Buys the mech, everyone groups up, and life seems okay. So crit not having really the easiest time here. Trying to transition his massive net worth into actually helping his team. As we go later and later, yeah, like Axe is still effective, of course, because he always pierces BKB. But when you're talking position one Axe, there's only so much momentum, you know, that you can carry out from a time like this if no one's helping you. So they're going to smoke up. They're going to try and use it with this first Necro. Pandago with the ulti, Squee with his ulti. It'd be a free kill on anyone they can find. The question is, will the Radiant see it coming with that ward? Were they under that? They were definitely under that. Yeah, they know the smoke's coming. Thousand percent. So great ward deep in there, knowing that's gonna happen.
Radiant's top tower has been denied.
Back themselves up. Maybe they're thinking about baiting, but it's too over the counter smoke coming out here. Radiant's dive vision, they get popped. They know they're in the trees, but it's only Pandago. Hello? Pandago! Oh, I found them, guys.
I think they knew we were smoking. So Fandango thanks the gangs. What the actual fuck? And now it's Fear who gets dunked on bottom by the rest of the team. Alright, Fandango Dota, ladies and gentlemen. Better question is, why did he check that shit? This is how you know they were smoked. Ulti comes out, it's gonna be on the crit, and Spotto in the tree line. Chase a little bit further, Squee. It's out there. Fortune Zen will come out and slow down Squee. Mopex re-chat. If you put my name, I will. What else am I supposed to check? Sorry.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Oh. I don't know. If you guys need anything, just type Mopex and I'll read it. You know, the old highlight. Shit. What the actual fuck? That's great. So what are we at now? 2K lead, Dire. Is OG boot camping in NA? Yes, I've heard they are boot camping in Canada. They're up here somewhere, probably Toronto, let's be honest. Fucking Toronto. Alright, crit. Blinks and Lima says, lots of creeps here for the spins. Half HP, laser comes with you, but RTZ, of course, pretty poverty when it comes to those damage skills. Like 2 points in laser, crit. Illusions running around here, but they are radiant owned. Stolen disruption, trying to get some spin. They are not getting lucky as well. No one's attacking them, so they can't really. They'll just be two heroes there for the dire side, but they don't lose RTZ, which is pretty huge. Of course, they don't kill MSS. Saying New Zealand sucks. It's not very nice. That sounds like something an Australian would ask for. Oh, is it Montreal where they're at? I don't know, there's someone in somewhere in Canada. MSS roared up, but you know, Tidehunter. There's a reason this hero got. I'll take that.
Radiant structures are fortified.
I mean, that was worth it. I can agree. I think MSS had a right for that question mark. It's like, it's almost as if Tidehunter was picked non-stop as a counter to Beastmaster for some weird reason. I just can't put my finger on it. It was something. Oh, jeez. Papina false promised. Papina saved himself, though. RTZ comes in and gets the kill. Crit Dota. He went for the blade mail. Standard item. No Timmy Hose. Yeah, maybe they aren't camera. Could they possibly be a Pandaic? Going for the ulti here on the Miracle, but Fear will be able to clean him up at the same time. Let's get the Valley Hunger though, so he will run away. Blink Dagger, I like this. The early blink. Skipping out on the next 2-3. Trying to help out. And this is really good because we talk about how Crit is so farmed and he can do so much around the map, but he needs assistance. He can't be on his own. He's an axe, right? Can't solo kill. So something like this early blink dagger is very important from the Beastmaster. And to counter the vision from the Beastmaster, the safety is going to be a very early Shadow Blade from Miracle. And I am also a fan of this because you think about how this is going to work, right? Dark side vision. Oh, this is huge though. This is massive. Did they ping it out? It's the question. Do they know there's a Shadow Blade? Witch Doctor, he bought wards. He didn't buy a sentry. I don't think they know. Oh, but here, now they know. Now it's getting X marked. They know he's got the Shadow Blade, and they know he's coming in right now. Hanging on to RTZ saying, get the fuck out of here. So good Hawk placement here from Tomato, understanding what's going to happen. And this is really going to delay his first kill with the Shadow Blade. But they're going to know the exact path he's going to take, and they might even smoke. Do they have any? This would be a really good time to dust smoke, and either look for Miracle, or just run down this way, knowing that he's haunting your jungle. Try and find someone else. I'm glad Hook. Glad to hear it. Top lane MSS. Oh, he's out. Wow, it's gone. Good place. Blink dagger done for MSS. It is the bots coming up now. Crit, but again, it's kind of like, he needs a friend. He's so lonely. Maybe this is the time. Blink dagger, Beastmaster. Teezy's got at least 4 points in Rocket. Almost a third into the laser here. There is some damage to help. Radiant are just blind on this part of the map. Very aggressive vision for sure. But it's looking to apply that same amount down to their side of the map, and they don't really have a good idea as to what they're up to. Meanwhile, Dire side, also very dark here for them. Ooh, this... TZ, he's fine. They know where he is. Oh, he wants it! MSM! They need more stuns! Oh, it's secondary blink! Good. Still get out. MS is thinking about it, but there's no follow-up stuns. I don't think Pepita could have made it. He probably could have offed the Ravage, let's be honest. They'd have to use the Haunt there. Right, you know, if they want to Haunt lead into something, it's definitely there, though. That is one thing, they get instant vision on the Tinker. I heard about those Nanyang finals, Sadidi. I really want to watch those. I saw the drafts and everything, and I saw the final result, but I'd like to go back and just check out how the drafts progressed, because it's pretty important to see like how teams are going to look at what Newbie and Wings did there, and see how they can carry that on, too. Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Really interested to see how it affects people. And by knowing the order it happens in the draft, you can try and figure out how that's impacting other games, right? When you actually see that influence. RTZ being very cautious here. Wow, look how long they've been up here and no damage to the tower. They don't have any push, unless Miracle's actively hitting the tower, but he's looking for some sort of a play in behind. Bottom lane, RTZ continues. Just split pushing top, bot, top, bot. Crit's not getting anything done. He's still really firm, for sure. But he's an axe, man. He wants to fight, he needs to kill. Alright, supports at least getting a lot. Yeah, they really are. Aether Lens, a little bit of casual wind lace, tranquil boots, Scream would love a blink, but 800 gold's pretty good. They'll have to invest in a little bit of detection. Probably gonna buy a gem for his Beastmaster, unfortunately. That's just the support life, you know. It's tough, it's tough. MSS has been farming very well, though. No surprise there. 300 gold. Net worth, rather. Yeah, Grant with the pause timer. Attaboy. He knows what's going on. Here's the blink. Pepita! Showing it off here. That's the freebie. And they'll even bring in fear. Give him a little bit of gold. Trying to get into that radiance. Can't really talk much about it. Oh, well, Paisley, you came at the right time, my friend. We're just talking about fear's items. Oh, and the radiance recipe. Oh, say goodbye to 400 gold. Crit Dota delivering the hammer, the blow via the axe. That's very disappointing. And they'll lose Pepita too, as well. So, radiance going to be a ways away. Oh, sorry. Yeah, I'm kind of forgetting that I'm doing like a real, you know, if I'm doing like an actual cast, camera wouldn't be so flingy. So apologies there. I can go back to usual shit. And the Shadow Blade spins. And what is this miracle? Who do you think? Oh, crit! Oh, can he find it? Nope. Crit. The hawk. Hello. You're under a hawk miracle. Oh, Squeeze actually body blocking crit. Now he can't get in because MSS Hunter's coming for the Ravage as well. And now it's crit and Squeeze. Trapped a little bit too close for comfort. Omni Slash comes out and he'll get it in time. Thanks to Purifying Flames of Kitrak. The Dire side diving a little bit deep there. Did they get anything back onto fear is the big question. And unfortunately they can't. No Haunt means he can't join that engagement. And he is very far away from that Radiance. Oh, that's not good. That's not good. Very important for the Radiant side once again, as I apparently hit Q there and went on the last hit, so apologies. 1,000 gold now for fear, 1350 required. The old Radiance recipe. Gotta get rich. Gotta get rich quick. And Haunt's back in 17 seconds, so already setting up for the next big smoke here. Oh, unfortunately, it's actually fear. Damage. It's all physical. The W not gonna help. It's gonna go for it now to prevent the damage from the E. and the rocket. That might be enough. Fear's gonna live. He can come back into this fight. Go back over to the engagement. Thaw comes out. Gonna find Pantego. Gonna be a little bit too late, though. Can't get the last right click off. And it'll just be RTZ that goes down, and that was to Papita. So we check to make sure that Fear's gonna live. And that's super important, because that is a Radiance recipe. Means it is fully completed and ready to go. And at the same time, MSS just keeping up this farm. He is so good. Guiding Greaves, Blink. Now going to be into that Pipe of Insight and up against the Tinker. Very important. You ever want to get high ground? It is the only way you're going to do it. At the Dire side, they're definitely on a little bit of a back foot right now. Oh, thanks, Aditi. I was a little bit confused there. But I don't want to give anyone the motion sickness, you know, I feel bad. But I wasn't paying too much attention to my camera, so I don't want to be that guy, you know, whipping the thing around too much, but... Oh, coming in. Donato... Not sure if he's aware. Miracle maybe guessing wrong on the 50. Oh, he sees the boar summon time. He's gonna know that there is a Beastmaster around here. What? Oh, Miracle. Oh no. This is a blink on Tomato anyway, so pretty hard to find him. I'm doing another quick check on the items here. So, a Shadow Blade into the Manta here. Pretty early timing here for Miracle. Vita again, that blink into his Arcane Boots. MSS working on that pipe. We just had our Radiance up. Meanwhile, the Dire, it is the classic, the new school Tinker build. It's going to be the Blink, Aether Lens, and the Aghanim Scepter for Arteezy. Crit moving into a Bloodstone? No. I really don't see why Octarine Core is an item, though. But it can't be a Bloodstone, right? It just sounds awful. Alright, I guess it's Octarine Core. Anyway, maybe I just missed that one, I guess. And Pandago. I guess it's not a BKB game? Not an Aghanim Scepter game? Crit shadowing Arteezy up here. Inside of vision, they don't know he's there. I mean, Bloodstone Axe is like, kinda good, but... I don't know. I'm not sure if I'm sold. Three goes down. Tries to save himself the disruption. And they're actually gonna try and smoke their way out. And in fact, it's gonna be smoking a little bit more aggression if you're gonna get the slowdown. Rid of the Q. Tomato. Just going down. Oh, Pandango, they saw him. And now blinking for Pepita. He wants more. A little bit of a freebie here, but he's actually putting him like Miracle on all accounts. And no blink dagger quite. Oh, Miracle. Pandango hesitating for a moment here, trying to create the gap, but he can't with the Gush now coming in and an Omni Slash to secure it. So it's a triple kill here for Miracle. The Aghanim Scepter's done, at least it's gonna be there for the high ground. Radiant structures are fortified. She'll be next here for Fear, no surprise there. And they're pinging the Roche Pit at its crit, saying they could be in here. See if he is correct. Silver Edge finished up here for Crit. Or sorry for Miracle. Wrong OG player. Speaking of which, on the hunt. Extra stats. There's the Shadow Blade in his inventory. Just a nice little pickup here. He wants our TZ. Oh, he's out of mana. Can they get Pepita here in time? He blinks forward, but not there. Our TZ just barely surviving. What's his kill score right now, by the way? Sorry, my hotkeys get changed between playing and action casting. Well, it's a little bit too late. There's a purge here. I'll be on the MSS. Whew, that is some easy damage. Arteezy is coming through. He is 3-2 and 3. Too shabby. Rockets flying out. Think about chasing onto Kitrak, and they will. Get the call from Crit. Another dunk, another slam, another kill. 2k gold on top. Could buy the Bloodstone now if he wants it. I think it's going to be the Octarine Core. You can see it, I mean, with the Berserker's Call. You can't argue with that for sure. Does Fear have Haunt? He does have Haunt. Can't find the opportunity for the Ravage. No one else close enough there. Capitalize on if MSS went for it. So the quick takedown mid, and is this it? Is this Roche timing? Be very risky with Ravage still up and not much benefit for them, honestly. Like, what's an Aegis gonna do? They're not going high ground anytime soon, I don't think. I think they still want like an item or two on Arteezy. It's gonna be split pushing a lot. I guess an Aegis would keep him alive, but unless it's a good opportunity, there's not really a lot of risk for it. Fireside getting Aegis would be pretty huge though. They got that on top of Fear, force him out front, force him to take him down first, even just Miracle, let him really YOLO into a fight. Could be big. Chris just waiting for the tick up here at this point on his Octarine Core. 10 more seconds. And Arteezy. Another pause. Disconnects. Grant's got us covered with the pause here, guys. Alright. 90 pings. Ooh. What are you guys saying, by the way? Sorry, I can't mega read chat. That's good. Hey, water? I do not have water. Now would be a good time, but it's too late for that. Oh, I have cold coffee. Yeah, it's like 2 days old. It's probably it's probably not gonna be too. Back. We're back. Right, so there it is, the Octarine Chorus. That'll be 7.5 seconds. Okay, alright. And you know, you goof on a dunk could be kind of good, right? A little bit bonus HP back as well. Okay. I like it. Let's do it. OG crit, ladies and gentlemen. Really isn't a very good Ags game for the Axe, so I kind of understand trying to find a secondary item. Here once again, and Dago just trying to get like a glimmer or something that would save him from this, and actually peek between a tier 1 and a tier 2 seems to be the answer. Crit in trouble, gonna get ravaged out of the Gover Pant. Dago, the ulti onto Arteezy too, that's 2 down straight away, and now Crit is actually calling Fear towards him and thinking, oh, this might have been a mistake. Can't find a blink out, and that is 3 dead for the Dire side. The Radiant have found their window, their opening, and I cranked it, 20-9. And I mean, it's not to say they were ever really down, right? It's been relatively even, but just slowly but surely this Axe didn't get his friends to help him out. Did what he could. Pretty much had the best early game you can really ask for on an Axe, at least in those first 6 minutes or so, but he didn't snowball that any further with any of his buddies. Fear got left alone. Arteezy's doing his thing for sure, he's trying to farm up, but you look at Miracle, 60. Think about how much Miracle's been running around in a Shadow Blade, and his farm is still this good. Having a very good game, honestly. 9-0-5. It's just like doing this shit loop over and over. It's still finding kills. So this is that Radiant Aegis. Well, it is a Radiant Aegis. I mean, let's crack it. Is on Fear. That's really gonna gushed up. He is going down. Tries to go for the purge as if that's gonna do anything. Oh, if only he forced that one with him, and maybe Arteezy can save him. In fact, that's an instant Aegis purge. We would. A little bit of a bait here, that is level 4 ladies and gentlemen, that's 50% on the Soul Catcher. But Miracle, he's coming through, he finds 2 right away, still has the Omni Slash. Oh, sorry, that was not the Omni Slash, that's just an illusion here, guys. I know, professional caster. We're coming out here on the kit rack, and oh my god, did you see that threshold? No Agate and Scepter required, and Crit's still finding basically max value there, it looked like. That experience change, though. Between those two. MSS, they're gonna use the Haunt on Zamato. They're gonna come in. He wants him. Fear? Hello? Oh, Fear's busy. He's chasing down onto Crit. No, they still want Zamato though. Oh, and they're gonna get Crit too. There's the call. Bonus armor, see if I can save him. Remember that Radiance Burn not being affected at all, and Miracle's here too. Oh. Only there weren't such an item as Radiance. Now Miracle, she's out of Pandago. He's gonna go for the turn. He actually makes it in time, but there's a Diffusal Blade. Miracle not even gonna waste the Omni Slash. No respect given here. MSS can just zone out Arteezy himself, and what looked like a slight glimmer of hope here for the Dire side turns into nothing.
I mean, Dagon purchased up here by Arteezy, but perhaps too little too late. Maybe some of it could have been a little bit better earlier on. As the Radiant side have taken a solid lead, I'm sure that'll balloon up to about 6k, and over time, no shocking surprise here. The way Miracles have moved around this map, and Fear as well, basically untouched, achieved over 15,000 variants on the Radiant. That's good. I mean, MSS, he's unkillable. He just roams around the map, got his gem, his blink, his pipe. 3.7k gold, he could go... I mean, Shiva's is really good against Axe and Beastmaster, honestly. But there's so many choices. He could just go for the Refresher. Actually, he doesn't have a Forest Staff, so his mana's kind of shit. I suppose the Guardian Greaves is okay. The plus 5 attributes. Needs a little bit of help from his friends when it comes to the mana boots. He happens to be a little bit low. Is that a Lincoln's, I guess? A good item. I don't think it's a Scotty. I don't really see the point. I think he's already unkillable. Lincoln's seems pretty legit. Smoke up play here? I don't know, just ancients. Oh, they do reveal Pandago's smoke though. Oh, maybe he didn't get spotted. I don't know. It's not like you just kill this warden and just immediately smoke up. It seems so obvious. Miracle's gonna Shadowblade. Do they even have detection? Nope. Nope. Oh, it is gem. My bad. My bad. Tied eggs? I mean, maybe. I wasn't looking at it. Did he just buy it? Crit possibly in trouble to get Tomato first. Nah, he's fine. Back over here. The laser and the prisms are flying through. I feel like it's the first time we've actually seen the Agnes Scepter really go to town in action. But it's MSS shut down the Agnes Scepter right away. Ho-hoo! Baby, give the Anchor Smash as well. Arteezy calls it a GG. And you can't really blame. That's a triple kill now. The godlike Miracle himself. The unkillable. The untouchable. The 15-0-7. Oh, man. After that Earth Spirit game, he is happy to be back on the carry roll. And showing the boys what he can do. 1406 gold in that last fight. What did he end up buying? Anything? Didn't quite catch it. He went for the... Oh, he bought something. We'll never know. It's a mystery. Lost all time. It was going to be a Lincoln's Miracle as well. Damn, that was pretty good.